Hey, what up, peeps? Hey, what's going down? Woo. I'm telling you, you know, I went away for a while. I came back. Glad I'm back. It feels good just to have fun again and do this reacting shit. It's fun to me. I see a lot of shit going down on YouTube, and I kind of like it all. I've been thinking of ways that that I'm going to change the way I do shit, because I'm more of a creative person than just a reactor. The truth of the matter is I love listening to new music, and the greatest part of my adventure being a reactor when I decided to do it was, you know, the community of people that I met, in particular the metal community. What a great group of people. I learned about all kinds of different new music, and now I'm vibing. I love it, and I learned a lot from that. I learned a whole new culture of music and people. And you know, to be honest, you already know if you've heard me tell the story on any of my videos, man, that liking metal and shit was not a thing where I was from. You know, we like rap and hip hop and, you know, gang shit and just crazy shit, right? That was just the culture. So I'm still a little sick. I haven't been able to breathe right for probably 2 weeks now. I know COVID and all that nonsense, whatever, I'm past it. But I'm telling you this right now, there's more to come for me in the future, and I hope that y'all get the opportunity to see, you know, shit that I consider creative, right? I'll let everybody know when that shit drops and when I start to do that, because it's gonna be a whole new avenue for me on YouTube. All I know about YouTube is that, you know, reaction videos are, to me, have always been kind of frowned upon. You know, even by myself, really. I mean, I watch reactors sometimes, I have a real hard time, because I'm like, you're so full of shit, and you're a liar, and you don't like this. You hate this, right? I've seen it happen a lot of times, but I'm not, you know, of course I'm not naming any names, because that's in general, and I can be a real asshole sometimes. Who gives a shit? I'm gonna stop talking, man. We're gonna check out Veil of Maya. There it is, I think I said it right this time. The song's called Synthwave Vegan. Fuck if I know what that means, but pretty sure I know what a vegan is. They eat a lot of meat and hate vegetables, and then a synthwave. That's that shit where your heart be like, fuck, I don't know. Don't worry about liking and subscribing and all that shit, because if you like me, you'll do it. If you don't, fuck it. Review breakdown. I'm not sure that I'm a huge fan of these new earbuds. These are monster earbuds, not sounding as good as my Samsung Lives, but of course I love the way the shit starts off. I mean, it's just, you know, metal. One good thing about metal is there ain't no bullshit. Like, get straight down to brass tacks, you know what I'm saying? Right in the middle of it, right from the beginning. Lay them to rest. Let me go back. I like the way that sound. I heard some kind of synth wave in there or some shit. And then, like, you know, the bass. And then the bass on top of bass. Yeah. Wow, what a turn, huh? That's cool the way it kind of goes together still. I'm going to go back because that kind of blew my mind when I heard that change. Let me pause it and take it back a little bit and see if I can catch it. I don't think I can catch it. I only know how to do the 5 second arrow shit. But look, drummers always they always got stylish shoes, right? But it's not just about style. It's clearly about comfort because they're always sporting some Nikes. My boy from Tribium does it, right? He always sports the Nike Cortez. This dude's sporting some Nike running shoes, and it's come clear to me that whether they're 1978 running shoes or 2022 running shoes are the best for the drummer. I missed it. Damn it. COVID, my bad. Big shout out to the Pastel Cartel, man. Got me coughing like crazy. I hate to be a dick about this, but you know my experience with metal. If you've seen my videos before, my experience with metal is about a little over a year old. That sounds like, it kind of sounds like something that I might play, like if I picked up a guitar right now. I don't know, and I could be being disrespectful and I don't mean to, but it just doesn't like vibe with the rest of the song to me. I don't know how to move to that, you feel me? I thought that said Slim American Records for a second. I was like, oh shit, a fucking Yellow Wolf popping off. Clearly it doesn't though. I've seen this record label somewhere before and I can't remember where it was. Maybe it was, you know, Veil of Maya. I don't know. But there's certain moments of that song where I was like, you know, like especially there towards the end, I didn't know how to move. Like, and I try to move, right? And the shit probably looks very uncomfortable for everybody, especially me. It's probably harder to watch, honestly, when I think about it, because I'm over here, you know, sipping a little vodka and some Monster Zero. But the song overall, the vibe is cool, right? There were second moments of that song where I was like, the bass drum with the bass guitar was really, really going nice. That little solo sector real quick, that was real nice. Of course, the growls and all those sounds, I love that. That's what I like about metal, right? That's my favorite part. My favorite parts about metal are crazy, insane drummers, and the guitars, of course, are great, right? I mean, that's expected, I think, and when it comes to any kind of rock music, but the drums and the growls are my favorite thing about metal, and I'm pretty sure I'm preaching to the choir, because if you like metal, you definitely have to like growls, otherwise you wouldn't fuck with metal, I don't think. And then the drums fuck, right? So there was moments where I didn't know how to move my body to it or even how to take it in. And that doesn't make it a bad song. The one thing that I wish that I would do is watch lyric videos, because I still have no idea what the song's about. The way I've always measured metal is by the sound of it. Like, how loud are you screaming? What's your tone when you're growling? And all that shit. That's the only measurement I have, right? One day, I will be skilled enough to understand metal or the lyrics they're trying to get across. I have a feeling that I'd be surprised by some of these metal lyrics, because I've seen some of them and it's like, wow, this, I don't know why this guy sounds like this when he's saying this, because it's not, you know, there's other ways to approach it. Fuck, it wouldn't be metal, right? It would be some punk ass shit that I don't want to listen to, so fuck it. The Veil of Maya, good shit. I'm so glad to listen to a metal song again, and you know, something I haven't heard, and it just makes me feel good. You know, my whole thing about metal was not, it wasn't to like get a new fan base of people and like get a group of people that would give me a bunch of views and give me clout or whatever the fuck these kids call it. But look, I'm so happy that I met the community of metalheads, because what a good community to be a part of. You know, I get so many ideas constantly. So please do me a favor. If I'm going to react at all, give me ideas, okay? I don't have a catalog of metal records to go through. I don't know what, you know, something that, point something in my direction that I'm gonna love, right? If you love it, the odds that I love it are pretty good. Because if you like metal, our brains speak the same language when it comes to like synthwave vegan stuff. Or whatever. Hell yeah, I enjoy this shit. So, I don't have a lot to say about it. Most of the shit that I have to say about it, even though this isn't a great example, is usually in between the music, but here it is, man. Veil of Maya, synthwave vegan. Somebody tell me what it means, please. I can't wait to check out some more. Let me make sure I didn't miss anything, because I have a good habit of missing shit. Nope. Didn't miss anything. Just did a reaction to this guy the other day. Hey, 0936. You got some good music, man. It's fucked up that you would block me, though. Such a small reactor. And all I'm trying to do is help you get out there, bro. Fuck, man. Reconsider it. My video's still up there. Hey, man. I appreciate y'all taking the time to watch me, man. So, hell yeah. I'm out for now, man. But I'll see y'all next time. We'll be right back.